Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Temi, a graduate software developer working in the UK, making videos about tech, careers, and all things in between. So if you've recently started learning to code, it might be a good idea to start putting together a portfolio of projects. So in this video, I'm going to give you some front-end, back-end, and full-stack project ideas to help you get started with building your portfolio. Keep in mind that some of these projects will require different levels of skill, so it's important to take a look at the list and see which ones match your experience level. Before I get into the video, don't forget to like and hit the subscribe button to see more content from me. So with front-end development, there are a lot of frameworks out there such as React, Vue, and Angular, but my advice would be is if you are a new coder or programmer, then try building projects without the frameworks just so you get a good idea of how the program works. So the first front-end project idea is to build a personal site. You can start by making your personal site similar to your resume, so you can add information about your experience, your skills, and maybe any interesting hobbies you have that are related to coding or programming, such as speaking at events or running coding workshops. So by building this project, you'll be picking up skills such as design principles, file linking, web hosting, and just general coding logic as well. The next idea is to build a rock, paper, scissors game. Building games is actually a really fun way to learn how to code. Apart from actually designing the game itself, you'll also have to build the logical robot that will play against the user. If you're already familiar with JavaScript, then you can actually use it to build this game, as it offers really good possibilities to create browser-based games. You can also build a calculator application. Building this will give you the opportunity to practice creating multiple layouts, and you'll use logic that includes math operators that will immediately provide your desired output. To code this application, you can use JavaScript, HTML, and CSS. Here are some good back-end development project ideas. So the first one is a meme builder. So with the meme builder, you can actually try and make it in two ways. So the first thing you could do is you could have kind of your site where the user can come on, they can pick a picture and a quote that you've provided and just mix and match and make their own memes. Or you could build your site in such a way that the user can come to your application, they can pick a picture that you've provided, and then just add their own text on top. And for either of these methods, there are several websites online where you can get free stock images to use for your application. The last back-end project idea is to build a favorite movie application. So you can start by using the movie database API to provide a database of movies that your user can select from. So you could build your app in such a way that the user can actually come onto your site and list, add, or even rank their favorite movies. So you can actually start by using basic CRUD API processes. So these would be create, read, update, and delete or destroy, I think. You can use these processes for each individual movie, and then later on just add any features that you want. If you know back-end and front-end development pretty well, then you can take on the challenge of building these full-stack applications. The first one is a weather application. You'll find that most weather apps that developers have built and displayed online will actually only show you the current forecast. So to make this project a little bit different, you could actually try and display the weather forecast for the next 5 to 7 days instead of just the current weather. Here you could use an API such as the Open Weather Map API, where you would focus on building endpoints, sending requests, and then rendering and processing the response. And this one you might find a little bit tricky depending on your expertise level, as you'll have to parse and process the response according to how you actually want to display your data. So I've actually built a weather application myself, and when I built this, I used technologies such as Node.js, Express.js, JavaScript, HTML, and CSS. And I know I said at the beginning that it's probably a good idea to not start off with frameworks, especially if it's your first project. But I think when dealing with APIs, some frameworks are actually good to use because they come with some built-in processes that make coding that much easier. So the last full stack application you could decide to build is an Instagram clone. And I know I said this about the meme builder, but this one actually sounds quite good and I feel like I might do this myself. But I think this would be a good application to build just because it would give you a better idea of the work that goes into building some of these social media apps that we tend to use on a daily basis. So if you were to build an Instagram clone, you'd learn the structure, styling, and the setup of the Instagram app. You'd also learn how to create new pages and set up routes. So these were just a handful of projects for you to work on and add to your portfolio if you're new to coding. I have left links to some blog posts in the description part of this video, which go into more detail about how to actually build each of these applications. So make sure to check them out. And do keep in mind that while following tutorials and courses are really good ways to learn, you'll actually learn the most by building projects and applications on your own. So if you have any more project ideas, then do let me know in the comments section down below. I'd love to hear them. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.